action of Islam and they became a what?
Muslim.
A who?
Muslim.
You want to be a what?
Muslim.
I use that one too in my programs. It's called instant shahada for everybody. I'll wrap it up there and go, no. As long as they understood this message, you've done your job. You have done your job. Did you communicate to them, there's one God, do what He wants you to do? If you'd like to carry it a step further, just a little bit further, you can ask them, do you have a prayer in your Bible that tells you how to pray to Almighty God? Hallowed be Thy name, Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. They all have memorized this. They don't know much else, but they memorize this almost like we memorize Ayatul Kursi. When you come to that part, God's will be done on earth as it is in heaven, that means Islam. Do God's will, not your will. Don't give in to your desires. Don't give in to your lusts. Do the commandments and then ask them, do you know about the Ten Commandments? What is the first commandment? The first commandment, it's in the book of Exodus, chapter 20, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 5. Just go read it, check it out for yourself, and it says, thou shalt not have any other gods beside God. The worship is for who? One God. Now some will say, well, that's Old Testament. That's true, it is. That's for the Bnei Israel. Yep. So what does the Bible say in the New Testament? And I'll give you the reference to that one for sharing with these people. Mark 12:29. Jesus was asked sarcastically, what's the greatest commandment? And he responded, it is to know, O Israel. You can see who he's talking to, Bnei Israel. To know, O Israel, the Lord your God is one Lord. How many? Everybody heard that? One? One Lord? One. And you have to worship Him with all your heart and all your mind and all your strength. Some translations say you have to love Him with all your mind and heart and all your strength. And this also is in Islam, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So show them you have this. Do you do it? They say, yeah, but three. You don't have three. It's not in your book. This came later. Our book is the last and the final revelation. The Quran came in the same exact family of languages as your Bible did. It came in the Semitic language of Arabic. Your book came in Aramaic. The Jewish came in Hebrew or Eber. And all of them said the same thing. La ilaha. There's no difference. Until somebody makes a difference. If you know about the first and second Maccabees in the Catholic Bible that doesn't appear in the Protestant Bible, you know already that there are differences that were brought about by their scholars of their times. That they used to divide up the people to try to call them to their particular minhaj or madhab. They did that. The Jews did it, the Christians did it, they have so many divisions. So if you see Muslims dividing into groups, realize they're doing the same mistake as their predecessors. It's not acceptable in God's plan for you to make a new religion. He has one for you. He's defined it for you. He told you the name of it. In Adina, in the Lahil Islam. And if somebody would like something other than Islam, وَمَمْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينَ فَلَا يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. He's never going to accept it. And most people are going to be with the losers. I'm going to end now with what I started with. I started out by talking to you how the last of the Quran came. It's the same in the beginning as it is in the end. And there's never any difference. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum Islam Adina. Allah said, on this day, I have perfected for you your complete way of life. And I have conferred upon you ni'mati, the possessive form of ni'mah, my biggest ni'mah, the biggest of all favors on you. And have chosen for you to submit, to surrender, to obey in sincerity and peace to the will of Almighty God. And may Allah put us on that deen too. Ameen. Amen. May Allah make us of the people who understand this deen.
Amen.
And share this deen.
Amen.
As the early people understood it and shared it.
Amen.
Ameen. And alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, huwa alladhi ja'alana muslimin. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك. Stay.
Stay.
I can't hear you.
Stay.
What?
Stay.
You want to hear your voice?
What do you think? Should we stay? Okay, he said okay. There was a lady, by the way, they're setting up, they're changing out their cameras, getting ready to do, you know, second part here. So while that's going on, there was a lady, she's not Muslim, she's been communicating with one of our Muslim brothers here, right here in Eastern Province, through email. And he told her, I have to go somewhere tonight to a program. And she said, oh, well, I hope you have good success with your program. As an afterthought, she put in there, unless it's one of those programs where you're trying to convert Christians, in this case, I hope you're not successful. And he wrote back and he said, well, it is, as a matter of fact, and we have an ex-preacher who's going to be given the program. Often we have folks who sit in the crowd who already know everything there is to know about everything in Islam, and all they have time to do really is just watch and see if we make a mistake. And I always delight them because I always make sure to make one mistake or more for them. So those mistakes that you saw were probably intentional. Do you like that? Kind of like, the most common question we always get, it says, how did you get to Islam? That's the most common question. Tell us about your story coming to Islam. How many of you already have heard it or watched it or read it? Raise your hand.
Want to hear it again?
Okay, about half the people here have already heard it. Well, now I have to tell you what Joha said. Joha? Yeah, you're not. Bled Hashem, Hamsi, Joha. You got it? All right. This is the famous character that people from the area called Bled Hashem, they always talk about this guy. But unless they're from Syria, because he's usually associated with Homs, which is in Syria, but if they're from there, they say, no, he's Turkish. We won't mention anybody's name who might be like that, by the way. His name is Ahmed al-Kurdi. Kurdi, you know Kurdistan, huh? Yeah. It touches Syria and Turkey, doesn't it? Yeah. Anyhow, I want to tell you what Joha said. They asked Joha to give a speech. He didn't want to give the speech. He said, give a speech. Oh, he got up there in front of the people and said, you know what I'm going to talk about? They said, yeah, go ahead. He said, you know, everybody know? They said, yeah, we all know. He said, then I don't need to talk about it. And he left. They got him up there another time. He said, come on, give a speech. And he got up there and he said, you know what I'm going to talk about? Well, they learned their lesson. They said, no, we don't. He said, then why should I waste my time? And he left. They got him up there again. They said, come on, give a speech. Come on, man. And he got up there and he said, okay, you know what I'm going to talk about? Half of them said, yes, we do. The other half said, no, we don't. He said, okay, those of you that know, tell the ones that don't know. And he left. So those of you that know the story about how I got to Islam, you can tell the rest of them.